You know, one might come back with the with this answer or this question, and they might say this: well, how come Yeshua told us in the words in red in the Gospels that we should love our neighbors as ourselves? Let me tell you why. First of all, he wasn't telling that to us. We didn't make an agreement to that contract. Yeshua was speaking to Israel, the nation who voluntarily agreed to perform that contract at Mount Sinai when Moses came down with the contract and presented it to them. And he read it to them, and he read the fine print that said there will be a reward if you can do these things. And he read the fine print that said there will be a curse upon you if you don't do them. And Israel looked at the blessing and the reward and said, oh, what a nice reward. No problem, Moses. We can do that. Go tell the Most High we can do that. And so when Yeshua came on the scene, he was challenging them about their own law that they agreed to perform, but they can't perform it because no one can be like the Most High and perform the Most High's perfect commands. So when Yeshua tells them, he says, come on, boys, love your neighbors as yourself. Come on. He's being sarcastic. Oh, you mean the Most High being sarcastic? Yeah! Whoa! What a concept! What's the definition of sarcasm? One thing is said, but another is intended. For example, nice weather, huh? But the weather's totally detestable. So when we apply sarcasm to the parables of Yeshua, when he tells Israel, love the Lord with all your heart, soul, mind, and strength, and love your neighbors as yourselves, he's saying, try as hard as you can, boys, but the only one that can do that is me. I'm the Most High in a man's body. You can't do that. Try as hard as you want, but it can't be done, boys. Only thing is, the boys didn't figure that out till after Yeshua died, took our eternal death, rose from the grave, and then sent the Holy Spirit into men's hearts to teach them. But he personally taught Apostle Paul. Personally taught him. And then the old boys start to saw what Yeshua was coming from. You see, they didn't get at all where Yeshua was coming from till afterwards. It was a delayed effect. Oh, wow. Because the apostles finally found out that those parables are describing what it would be like if a man could actually perform the law of Moses. He would be like the man who built his house on the rock. What's the rock? The commandments, the perfect commandments. The rock that can never be shaken. Anybody that can be perfect like the Most High will have built his house on the rock and will have earned his eternal life back. There would be no need for the saving plan for that man. No need for the Messiah. No need for the Most High to come down in a man's body and fulfill his own commands. For that man would be able to get right through the narrow gate. He'd be one of the few. But remember, Yeshua's being sarcastic, and one of the few is actually none at all. This is why the apostles don't quote the parables. Now think about this. You would think that the parables would be the most awe-inspiring words to speak upon. Everybody says, the words of Yeshua. Such reverence is held so high for those words. But nobody knows. We just don't know why those words are actually spoken. But the apostles came to know. That's why they don't quote those parables. They don't put those parables as a pattern for the new commandment lifestyle. The new commandment, the attainable commandment. That commandment says, just love one another. There's no high standard on it. He's not telling us to love our neighbor like we love ourselves. For the real definition of that is go out and work 3 jobs for your 24-hour day and make sure your credit card's packed with money so all your neighbors can use it too. For if you loved your neighbor as yourself, he would have the same access to all your credit cards as you do, as well as your kitchen and your bed. So tell me, who around here thinks they can love their neighbors as themselves? Who around here? I think everybody around here knows what the answer is. Ain't nobody can love their neighbors as themselves. But they can love one another. What's the definition of that? Well, if you start to study the scripture, you'd see when Paul says that, sometimes, and a lot of the times, the next verse he starts talking about in the communication of your lips. The new commandment, love one another. And the communication of your lips. In other words, when we speak the real story out our mouths, this is how we show love for one another. For a man cannot be saved unless we show that love to him. And then Apostle Paul says, well, since how you're not under the demand of the high standard of the law now, demanding you to be nice, he says, and while you're at it, be nice to one another. Treat each other kindly, man. But get your eternal life first. So the priority is on speaking what the true gospel is to one another. And then secondarily is our conduct, how we treat one another. And we treat other other people nicely because, not because we're demanded to do it or we're told to do it, but because now we don't have to do it. We do it because we choose to do it. Oh, oh, oh. Oh. Of them that bring good news.